Hello my dear friend, this is Phil again, and very welcome back to my channel. So in this episode, I'm going to give you a guide on how to become addicted if you want to do a janky build. So what cam is the best to get hooked for a janky build, and how do you get them? And here is a full list of addictions you can get in the Fallout 76 game. I got this list from the Fallout 76 wiki, which is basically a very good resource for all kind of information about the game. So here, as I'm marking red, the Mantis addiction is the best for any janky build because it only minus one of your charisma. And for janky build, charisma probably is the most irrelevant special. So if you want to do a janky build, Mantis addiction is the number one addiction you want to go for. And the Mantis are very easy to get across the Appalachia. You can buy them from various vendors, which I will show you in the later part of the video. Then from top to the bottom, I would recommend alcohol addiction. Again, it's very easy to get, but for all the addictions, it only takes 3 to 6 to get you hooked. And apparently alcohol is one of the most easy resources you can find across Appalachia. You can buy them from all the vendors. And minus one charisma and minus one to agility. Charisma, we don't really mind. Agility, actually we do. If you are a commando build or pistol build or rifle build, you will need agility to help you to stay in vats as long as you can. So I would recommend this addition for all the heavy builds as well as melee build. The buff out addition is not very good. It's a minus one to both in duration and strength. That means you have less HP and less carry weight. I personally would avoid this one. And Calmax, a minus 2 to both perception and agility, which are both important for commando and pistol build, which are heavily relied on vats. And I actually recommend Daddy O addiction for heavy build, a minus 1 to both perception and intelligence. Both specials are less important for any heavy build as well as melee build. Day Tripper is actually another one for all janky build. A only minus 1 to both charisma and luck. Fury addiction, minus 1 to strength and minus 1 to perception. So basically heavy build and melee build will rely on strength, and commandos and pistol will rely on perception. So I wouldn't recommend any janky build to take fury addiction. For repeat addiction, well, in addition to how hard it is to get, it actually minus 2 to both charisma and luck. I wouldn't recommend this because we have better choices. The Maddox addiction and psycho addiction, they both do minus 10 to DR, which is the ballistic resistance, but this minus 10 figure is almost neglectable. I don't really care if I have 10 points of DR less. It won't cause any real problem in your daily combat. But Maddox addiction also minus 1 to agility. As I mentioned, if you do vats a lot, you would avoid Maddox addiction. So if you want to do a heavy or melee janky build, then you can definitely go to Maddox. It's very easy to get as well. Psycho addiction actually minus 1 to strength. I would avoid melee build to avoid this one. But for all the other builds, it can be a potential option. XL addiction, definitely now a minus 1 to all the specials. I have no idea who will take this addiction, unless by accident. Okay, that's all addictions I would suggest. Then I will show you how do you get Mantids, how do you get alcohol, how do you get Daddy-O, how do you get Day Tripper and Maddox and Psycho in the game. So first of all, you want to go to West Spring Station and go in there to buy things from the vendor bot. He normally have a lot of alcohol in stock. As you can see here, you have bourbon, lager, pickaxe, vodka. If you don't find enough, you can just do a server hop. They normally have plenty of them. Just keep on drinking 3 to 6 of different alcohol gonna get you hooked. That's one addiction sorted. You only need 5 addictions to maximize your janky weapon damage output. If you didn't find enough camp here, you can go to West Spring Resort. There's another Dr. Vanderbilt who sell more camps. So here we are. You're going to the resort, turn right. The first shop on your right is the camp store. This is Dr. Stanley. Talk to him or her. You will find he has plenty of stock available for you. There are enough Mantids, day trippers, Mad X, even cycles to get you hooked. So this is the best place to buy all sorts of medicals. I already did a few server jobs, so I have plenty of day trippers and mantis to get me hooked. Now let me get hooked with Daddy-O and day trippers. So Daddy-O probably is the most difficult camp you can get inside the game. It spawns in fixed locations. There is a very good tutorial on where to find them. I'll give you the link below in the description part. You can follow that to get plenty of Daddy-O to get yourself hooked. If you didn't get enough camps from both West Spring Resort and the West Spring train station, you can come to the Foundation and talk to Sunny. He normally have plenty of camp stock as well. You see, he has Mad-X, he has Mantis and Furies. So now let me get hooked with Mad-X. Wow, it took me 6 of them to get hooked. So far, this is the most camp I needed to get hooked. All the others took me 3 or 4 to get hooked already. I already got 5 addictions: alcohol, Daddy-O, Daytripper, Mad-X, and Mantis. And if you think getting Daddy-O is troublesome, then you can definitely get hooked with Cycle, which again you can buy them from these 3 vendors. Every time you get hooked, you need to wait until the camp's effects faded. Then you're gonna see the addiction inside your Pip-Boy. Okay, that's all for today. If you like this video, please give me a thumb up and remember to subscribe to my channel and share my video with your friends. That will be very much appreciated. But until next time, Phil Liggins out.